Hello and welcome to this exam question video. We're carrying on from a previous video on synovial joints. If you haven't seen that one just yet, then perhaps go and find that video on the channel or inside the portal, wherever you are watching this video, where we labeled this image up here. It's the knee joint. What we did was break it down on the whiteboard and we labeled all the different structures that are found inside of a synovial joint, from the cartilage, to the capsule, to the membrane, to the ligaments, to the synovial fluid, to the cartilage, and to the bursas. So what that question was talking about was labeling the synovial joint. So that's what you need to be able to do, is just label the structures. But this follow-up question then asks you to not only identify the structure, but also to describe its function. What role does it play in helping the performer, helping to prevent injury, helping the smooth running of a joint? And in this question, they're asking you to pick one of the structures, which is labeled above, so A or B, which is our cartilage or synovial fluid. But this could be absent of the diagram, and you might just have to pick one of the structures or a couple of the structures and then describe their function. So if we just take the two in this diagram to start with, which were cartilage and synovial fluid. So let's start with the cartilage. The function of that, well, it's to reduce friction. It's to prevent the bones from rubbing against one another, because if they were to do that, that would cause a lot of pain and possible breakages in the bone, as well as it would build up with friction and heat. So that joint would start to creak and crunch, and it wouldn't be able to move through its range of movement as easily as it could do with healthy cartilage in place. They're also there to absorb shock. So they're laid over the ends of the bones where they might compress and contact each other. And if that were to happen, then the impact would be felt in the bone. But because the cartilage is there, the cartilage can absorb it, almost like a bit of a buffer, a shield. It absorbs that impact and then dissipates it out towards the sides, protecting the bone underneath. So we've got the friction and we've got the shock absorption benefits. If we were to talk about synovial fluid, well, the main function of synovial fluid is to lubricate the joint. It's to lubricate all of the structures inside that synovial joint, so that when they do articulate and when they do start to move around each other, they're greased up and they're lined with this slippery, almost gel-like, oil-like substance known as synovial fluid. As a result, when surfaces do start to pass over each other, we don't see friction beginning to be created, causing heat, causing this joint to slow down, causing more force to be required to move that joint. So synovial fluid is good to prevent the friction from building up, and it can also help replenish and almost provide nutrients to the structures inside that joint as well. So within the synovial fluid, there are going to be nutrients that are supportive to cartilage regeneration, cartilage overall health. So what replenishes the synovial fluid? Well, if we had to label the joint capsule, which was this lighter gray zone around the exteriors of the joint, well, the joint capsule is there for the structure and the support of the joint, but lining that joint capsule is the synovial membrane. So if we were to write down the structure of the synovial membrane, what function does that serve? Well, it's there to replenish and secrete synovial fluid so that it stays healthy, it stays fluid, it stays liquid, it stays responsive to temperature changes so that it can continue its role of lubricating the whole joint. The joint capsule is there to support that joint structure, to help prevent with absorption of impacts from external sources, for example, a lateral hit to the knee or a lateral hit to the elbow. It's there to absorb that impact, dissipate it around the edges of the joint, and then sort of get rid of it towards the side. It doesn't let it sort of penetrate through the joint where damage could be caused. And that's that. So for your exam questions, make sure you not only know the structures of a synovial joint, you don't know, you need to know where they are on a joint, but you also need to know the functions of them as well. So I hope that helped, and I'll see you again in the next video. Bye for now.